Clive Jordan in Southern California is going to present on that screen on the left. So Clive, the floor is yours.
Hey everyone. I don't know whether you can see me, but I thought I'd just say hi. I won't burden you with my ugly mug. I'll say hi and bye. But thanks so much, everyone, for joining us. We are Planerly. It's a pun on not planning late, but planning early. So plan early. And we are a BIM management platform. Our motto, our belief of this concept of smart, lean BIM, we define that as being the right BIM at the right time, by the right people, and specifically for the right reasons. So that's what we're really focused on, is the right BIM, the right time, the right people, and the right reasons. And it's really important because BIM can be used for so many different things. We've got everything from marketing to analyzing the building, running clash reporting, quantity takeoffs, viewing, walking through the building, even using it for facilities and operations. And so with all of these different uses, there are a lot of different amounts of development, detail, accuracy, information that are required at certain points in time. And if we don't get that right, what we see in our industry is the opportunity to unfortunately have a lot of miscommunication. And what we see here are three models, three BIMs, building information models, and they might be perfect, each one of them, for the customer, or it might be way too much detail. And so getting that right and communicating between the owner for what they would like as a handover requirement, or what the contractor needs to coordinate, or what the architect needs to actually cut drawings and make that workflow more efficient for them. It's really important to get that right because it's a cross-company problem. And as our industry, with the AEC tools that we have, we've got a lot of fantastic authoring, analysis, and use tools that are dedicated for BIM. But we have been using business-related tools that are disconnected from each other and also disconnected from the rest of the workflow to plan and control and manage that process. So understanding that as a challenge, that was where we set off, where we started. And we identified all of these difficulties that we have when you're trying to create a BIM execution plan to manage this process. Sometimes it takes a long time, and when you create one, nobody actually reads it. And there's unclear responsibilities when we're trying to manage this responsibility matrix in an Excel table with a bunch of numbers. We end up with the confusion as to who is supposed to do what when, and too many clashes because models are created at the same time rather than potentially in the right sequence. And all of these challenges are what we focused on 3 years ago when we started on this journey. And our whole emphasis was connecting and making this process a lot more efficient, creating one simple cloud-based BIM management platform. And the exciting thing is that we have now simplified that workflow from planning right the way through to verification that we have met those objectives. The planning starts with BIM execution planning templates to make that BIM execution planning workflow so much more efficient. And then scoping to ensure that we know who does what when, and also then tracking, scheduling and tracking that process in the management workflow, right the way through to dropping the deliverable in and verifying that it was completed. So what I'm going to share with you today is an overview of the product in a couple of slides. And then I'll dig in to the platform and show you a live presentation as we walk through the software. And then hopefully I'll leave a lot of time for questions so that we can dig in if there's anything specific that comes up. So the first module, it's called Plan, and it's about simplifying the BIM execution planning process, allowing you to drag and drop from all of the templates, whether they are industry standard templates or your own templates for your company, and creating those processes and contracts so that everyone can really understand what's going on. And it looks like this, the plan module. We have editing in the browser. It's all browser-based. Rich information, whether it's tables, text, videos, anything can go into one of these sections. We then have commenting process and a publishing process, which starts off as in progress, sharing and publishing. This is following the ISO standards for work in progress and through to publishing, and allowing you to invite the teams and be part of the workflow as these contracts are created. So that's the plan module. The second one is the scoping. Today, we use sometimes a spreadsheet to create something that really can be very powerful if it's visual. And we've seen the ability to understand something when it's visual, like we are able to in this visual grid, it increases the awareness and the adoption and the likelihood that people are really going to deliver on those promises. So being able to, in a visual and collaborative framework, define the geometry, the documentation and information requirements for each party at each milestone in the project, or at just one milestone if it's simply a contract for a deliverable. So it looks like this, the scope module. Each column represents a milestone. So we have the structural estimate, the MEP, the asset handover, and then we have a, whether we're following uniformat, uniclass, any classification structure, all of the line items to represent exactly which items we need, and then a definition rich and filled with either information requirements or attachments and links and all of the data required to understand exactly what is needed and who is responsible. And even seeing a handover from the architect required to provide something early on for the structural estimate, and then the MEP coordination, the stairs here are the structural team's responsibility. So understanding who is responsible, when it's required, and what the purpose is for that model, really powerful and visual in that scoping grid. That's the second module. The third module is all about sequencing and not putting a burden on the team to schedule and manage those tasks, but actually it's the BIM timeline that teams manage to give together. They build and manage this sequence. We've got case studies that have shown 53% fewer coordination issues because teams are now sequencing their work for a clash avoidance workflow rather than a clash detection workflow. So the schedule is really visual again, and a lot of drag and drop, being able to sequence your own tasks and filter for your own tasks and manage your own tasks in the same system that everybody else is also managing. Really simple in scheduling. And then the tracking module allows teams to manage their own tasks, focus on continuous BIM delivery, and make it a lot easier for those that are managing the BIM process to see where the status is on those tasks without having to request every day for an update. So a very simple drag and drop. He's got three tasks and he simply drags and drops to say that it is ready for review, the stairs. And that's where the verify module comes in. At the end of that workflow, whether you have followed every step or not, you have a deliverable and we have a set of tasks, and we're really wanting to simplify that BIM compliance workflow so that the model dropped in, connected to the requirements, can allow you to make sure that those deliverables are fit for purpose before we waste time using or distributing them to other team members. So in this example, we're seeing that the stairs and the common areas, they're checked off, whatever the requirements were and whatever the attachments were, we are verifying based on the requirements that this is something that is ready and it's fit for purpose, whatever the customer requirements were. So this is Planoly in five modules. Let's take a look at Planoly. The first thing to note is that there are different levels of permissions, and we can set up accounts for teams with their own branding on so that it is a looks and feels like your own company account. And then there's a concept of workspaces, and in each workspace we have projects. So this project that I have, I am the manager on the project. And if I simply enter into the project, I can see all of the details about the project. I can see links to different tools that we're working on and using on the project. And I can also see all of the team members and their contact details if I wanted to, and their permissions. So this front page is all about the project. If we jump into the plan module, we can see the plan sections that we have created. And here I can show you that we've got everything from rich content in here as videos that we could play back, and tables and text, etc. But how do we get them in there? Well, the library on the left-hand side is where we would access all of our standards and templates to create a BIM execution plan. And if we were looking for a coordination process, we could simply find, this is a BIM use that we're going to add, and I'm going to drag and drop it into the right-hand side. And I'm going to talk about, for that, we need our project coordinates. And we also need to understand, maybe that's good. So Here we go. We have two sets of, and actually I wanted to drop them in here so I could just move them up. And you'll notice as I drag and drop them, you see that the number changes. So if I drag and drop it in section two, it will update to 2.1. We can then edit these in the browser. So I can start to manage and edit this content. We can, based on the people who are in the system, can come in and comment. And then we can go through the publishing and the process of approval and getting this content out. So I don't want to spend too much time on each of these modules, but just to show you how that works and how we drag in from the library. Then if we move on to the scoping, this is where we would set up each of the milestones for the project. And I mentioned it could just be one milestone. And each of, whether it's a bid package or a set of scope that follows a breakdown that your company uses, what you need in each of these, and whether it's spaces, and let's dig into something that's, so there's structural, for example, some columns, and do we need it in 2D? Do we need it in 3D? Do we need certain information requirements? Do we have notes about each one of these? And who is responsible? So the BIM team, the owner, the architect, simply showing who is responsible. Same principle, this is all built from either your standards or the industry standards. And there is a library that comes out of the box that you can start with that ranges from all of your building elements and also civil and hospitals, etc. All of this is out of the box, airports, etc. And also out of the box are a set of templates from around the world. And whether it's OmniClass or Uniformat, whether it's something in French or in English or a bunch of different standards from around the world that are available. We also follow, and I should mention, if you do use the LOD standard, at the moment it's not shown because this project is set to not use a standard like that. But if we were to choose a standard, one of the recognized standards, this would now allow us in the scope to understand what the LOD was. So at coordination, an LOD of 350, and we can see if I move this up or down, say for example, we wanted to also include the reinforcement. So you can start to see how these build up. Not wanting to go into too much detail, but you can build a scope for one deliverable or a series of deliverables for that project. Each one of those cells becomes a task on the schedule that you can then manage and control. And this is the great point part about this is I would ask teams to do that themselves, not just myself, and then track and understand the status of those tasks so that we know what is ready for review. And the items that have been dragged and dropped into ready for review, we can then go and view the deliverables. I mentioned that this would be called verify, because really this step is now being able to visualize the deliverables and also verify that they have met the requirements that we were looking for in the first place. So here we have the 3D model, and I can zoom into the model and understand what's here. I can interrogate the model by clicking on items, seeing the properties of them, etc. Or I can click through these. So here we've got the concrete stairs. We can identify where they are in the building, the columns, here we've got the curtain walls, etc. And we can also understand the relationship of those in as far as whether they have been verified or not. So by bringing up our show linked, we show verified as well, I can start to identify what in this model has passed the test, what has been linked, and understand those pieces. And then I could also even cluster, I love this one, I can group those items in their respective categories, and we can see their status in that same setup. So let's quickly show how that works in a standard model as well. So here, if I wanted to, instead of, which I could walk around this model and I could look at every single one of the light fixtures, for example. But instead of having to look at every single one of those light fixtures, what about if I grouped them all, I clustered all of those light fixtures, and I can then look at all of the light fixtures here, all in one place. A lot easier to review and a lot easier to manage. if there are questions, we can dig into a lot of the detail. Just let me know how much you want to dig in and how much you want to eat pizza and drink beer.
Anybody have a question here?
Clive, just generically from the highest level, can you speak to just the licensing and fee structure, something like this?
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. I like the fact that we can just jump straight to the price. So we have many different ways to make sure that you are 100% happy. We start at free. And so you can literally go online and register, join free and start to go through the whole experience. It gives you unlimited projects, unlimited workspaces, unlimited viewers, 2 people to edit on every project. And then there are some restrictions, but as soon as you feel that it's ready for you, then we just talk and you can either buy 1 project at a time, which starts at $9 per project. As soon as you think it's for you is to set a meeting with one of the team, and we will define a plan with some huge discounts, because I've been on both sides of the software selling and also the software buying experience. And we are trying our best not to create any sales team, because we hate that workflow. We know that we just want to remove the limits and give you guys as much use as possible, and understand that that's not going to happen overnight. So long answer to say, you can start free and we can set up a plan for your company that is very, very attractive based on the amount of use that you think you might have in the first year.
Any other questions?
How many sales do we have?
Oh, all the arms are up right now, Clive.